We come in front of your throne this morning. We are waiting to hear from you, our God and our Father. We just know at which times we are living, and we realize that these are not always moments of peace. Therefore, Jesus Christ, our peace, indwell us this morning. Open yourself to us. Help us to understand how and where and the means of keeping peace in our homes and within ourselves now and always. Amen. I just want to greet the Church of Jesus Christ this morning. Good morning. It is a Mothering Sunday, and I think every mother is appreciative of the fact that God has given you life to this year, the Mothering Day. Are you happy? Are you happy to be living? Yes, we are happy because we know that Jesus Christ is our peace. And the Bible says that therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot have peace unless you have been justified through faith by the Lord Jesus Christ to God and maintain that peace. I think we are all residents of Thika, residents of Kiambu, and we are sure when we are witnesses of how many things have happened in our surroundings, in our environment, that do not indicate peace. We have had murders in our families. We have witnessed women being beaten up. We have witnessed every kind of social injustice because of lack of peace. And in this year, 2017, which is an electioneering year, we are also going to witness some more. For you and I, if there is anything that we need more than all that we can be given by God, it is peace. It is peace. You need peace, my sister. You need peace, my brother. You need peace, whatever you do. And peace in this land also. But for the children of God, we need to know the source of peace so that we can keep peace within ourselves. You cannot give what you don't have. You cannot give your children a peace that you don't contain. And many of us women, we need to go back to the Holy Spirit and ask him, how much of your peace do I have? We could be very well used to be chaos in our families, just like Rebecca. I think somebody prayed in our intercessory prayer, a prayer concerning Rebecca. But we know that she initiated the fight between her two sons, who were also sons. I mean, twins. She had a favorite, and she had one she did not honor very much. And she cooked some mischief. And that is how Jacob ended up getting the birthright inheritance, because he was instructed by his mother, Rebecca, to swindle his brother, Esau, and get the inheritance. Mothers, you need peace, the peace of God, and even the knowledge to know that it is God who gives. It is God. All your wealth is in the hands of God. The other thing that the Holy Spirit would like us to reckon this morning is that as we have and wait and look forward for the divine expansion, there is no need of God expanding us to anything if we don't have the peace of God to administer the blessings that will come with the divine expansion. What good is it for us to have material wealth? What good is it for us to be rich, mamas? We have goats and cows. We have posh houses. We have the softest carpets in our houses. We have everything that we desire, and there is no peace of God. Does it work? Would it help us? Would it benefit you? Even if you had the millions that any woman would need, would it benefit you without peace? We need peace. We need peace. And the peace of God comes only through the knowledge of Jesus Christ. If you could be here in this church and you're not a witness of the goodness of God, then you will be far away from what God would like you to be, the place and the position that God would want you to possess. There are so many benefits that come with peace. And one benefit that comes with peace is it expands your confidence. How many of you have sat for examinations? Examinations, I'm sure there are many people who have done exams without peace. Can you be able to remember what was taught? Even if you studied the whole night, even if you woke up at 3 a.m. for an exam at 3, would you remember? I am a student, and I know how baffled I am and how useless I become in my performance if I don't have the peace of God right from my house. I must have the blessing of my children, the blessing of my husband, the blessing, you know, the calmness that comes only from knowing God. The confidence comes from there. And it is there that as I write, that if I fail to remember what is needed, that I'm able to call upon the Lord. Because I'm confident He will not let me down. Confidence. You may not be a learner, but there are so many things that entail our lives where we need the peace of God. Why do you think people are hating one another and killing and murdering? Why do you think somebody would kill an elderly woman? Is that a picture of a lot of peace? Would anybody prowl around and kill Pastor, what is his name? Pius Muiro's mother, when they have peace? Would we have witnessed the murder that we witness around of Mrs. Joyce Gedito? Was there peace in that homestead? Ladies and gentlemen, our sons and our daughters, what could have been lacking if we have that picture in our mind? What could have been lacking in that family? Is it money? Is it houses? Is it cars? Was there anything that anybody would have wanted? How many children, and I'm sorry to dwell on that for any moment, how many children were in that family to inherit finally when that lady goes in peace? Was there anything but lack of peace? You are just so agitated. You are just so irritated about everything, and there is no peace. The peace of God, which passes all understanding. When you don't have the peace of God, even being responsible of the others, as God expands you, it will not be there. God can open doors, but you cannot see them. You'll be totally blind. There is a door open for you to accumulate wealth, because after all, the Bible tells us that it is God who gives us the plans to make wealth. Do we need to murder one another? Do we need to be destructive in order to win and to have it? How many of us, and I want to address this to the gentlemen, are wearing two suits today? Two at the same time. How many of you are in two trousers or two panties today? Tell me. How many of you ladies have got a tunic on and another one on just to make people understand that you're not lacking in clothing? It is only one at a time. And if we know God who is able to provide, in that peace you will wait, even if it is tearing. It will not tear, because the God of Israelite is your God. He led them through the wilderness, and for 40 years, none of them went to the butter stalls to look for a shoe. None of them walked the street to look for a pair of rubber shoes to walk. They wore it for 40 years. Kwani wewe uko na miguu gani? Kwani wewe unataka kuvarishwa namna gani? We may be hungry, and we are needing a lot of food, and people are hungry in our country. But we keep eating from morning to evening. We need only 3 meals per day. I mean, what are you despising the other one for? Where is your peace even to think of that other person? And with that, I want us to be remembering or to be reminded by the Spirit of God that we need to think of those others. Not just me. Just like you feel hungry, so do the others. Just like you think of yourself as wanting to possess this or the other, so do the others. We all have needs, we have aspirations, we have, all kinds of desires the human has been bestowed with by God. And this I want to address to Dr. Shege. We need to visit the hungry in this district or this county, if not northeastern, because we are more than rich in Thika. We are more than rich. The peace of God will give us understanding to understand those other people. Think of that woman who walks onto the road that passes through her shanty home, waiting for a vehicle to pass by and borrow a drop of water. Has God brought you to that state? How many of us in Thika are here in the church without having taken a bath? Did you take a bath? Yeah, people in our country are looking for a cup of water to drink. Have you thought about them? Because God has given you peace. The peace that, God would want us to have is a peace that thinks about the others. The peace that gets pained to see the others suffering. The peace that lead away and sees, yes, I need to do something because I have more than enough. We cannot even count our blessings without peace, ladies. You just see what you are missing. Eh? We are known to throw up our hands and say, hao ni wale wamebarikiwa, hao ni wale wakonayo, wale wanaenda, wanapeanda kwa mana wakona surplus. You don't give because you have surplus, you give because, like we have read in one of the texts this morning, because God has given you and you are not even worried about tomorrow. You have the peace that tells you even tomorrow God will supply. You never exhaust God. Do you know his thoughts? All cattle on 1,000 hills belong to who? To the Lord. Therefore, you cannot give to me na ujimalizie. God will open doors for you then. The peace of God that passes all understanding, so that what you don't know, you may know today. The peace that does not have time to despise that other person because of how they look like. We are all in the image of God, whether we look handsome, beautiful, whatever we are. And the peace of God helps you to understand. And, as you take pride in who you are, you also think of that other person, the peace of God. Colossians says, let the peace of Christ rule in your heart. Since as members of one body, you will be called to peace. And be thankful. Let the peace of God, as you hurry, because there is nobody else in the world who is in such a hurry like the Kenyan, and that is why we meander on the highways, we kick one another around, we lock, our cars together like this, that none of us is going. Have you been in such a scene? The drivers do not, even how to give one another way. Eh? And every one of us is grumbling. Acha huyu mjiga amenifugia njia. Anafikiria naenda wapi? Kwani wewe ndiye ulikuwa unaenda wapi? We have to be shown how to organize ourselves. Unless the government is there, unless a policeman is there, we don't have the peace even to make way for one another. And that time when we are grabbing like that and blocking the path and blocking the road and whatever, aren't we wasting time? The very time that you are saying you need, so you spend it there in that jam which you have created. Lack of peace. Lack of peace. If you are peaceful, we would be driving along the Thika Highway. Eh? You can imagine how much time we waste there on the flyover coming to this town. Just because there is no peace. Let's have the peace of God to help us understand, help us control ourselves. And women, we want the peace of God to dwell within us. We have been accused, rightfully and wrongly, of our kupayuka. It will not take us a lot of time before we have said one or two things. And sometimes we brag about it. Yes, you said, so what? It only showed lack of peace. If you had the peace, you wouldn't even dare waste time on primitive things, saying silly things for to be understood. You don't need that. And in fact, we bring others to thinking when we keep quiet. But how many times do we like keeping quiet? Tuonekane wanjika, apana, sio mimi. Nitamwambia, hata yeye ajue nafikiria. Who knows that? Who doesn't know that you have a head? And the head has a brain, and the brain is for thinking. Keep quiet and give yourself the respect you deserve. Consider things once and again before you utter any word. Because you have the peace of God, let people know that the peace of God dwells within you. It is not you, but Christ who reigns within you, who lives within you. Wengine tunasema, ukikimia, utaonekana mujiga. Ukikimia kwa hao wafanyi kazi, watakutawara. It's not true. In fact, if anything, they will weigh and see that it is because you think deep that there is a well of peace within you. Mama akimi kwa mana hajuira kusema. Lakini ni kwa vile Mungu amemjaa, yeye anakimia. How much do we disrespect the Spirit of God by answering for ourselves? Can we be two on the throne? Kuna throne even in this world iko na wawili. Kama unataka kujitetea, endelea ujitetee. We will see where you reach. The peace of God that passes all understanding and helps you also to understand as God expands the responsibilities, what responsibilities you have. We are thinking that our youths have got no metugo, matire metugo. But if there is anybody who is lacking metugo, it is us, our mama, our baba. Ask me how. It is by those utterances in front of them. It is by those deeds we say, and I don't care. Wacha atete, ata leo, ata ni mimi. The modeling we do in our families is such that our children have got nothing actually, and they take those tempers back to school and burn their schools. You may not agree with me, but it could be very true. We are in very bad times. The money is not stretching the way we want. We are not feeling comfortable. There is drought if it is in such a particular time and food is not stretching the way we want it. But God has not let us down, has he? Has God let us down? So we need the peace of God. When the shearing is not doing what it ought to do, then the peace of God ought to stand where the shearing stood. And we need the peace of God more than the shearing, because the shearing gets devalued. But the peace of God does not lose its value. The peace of God. The peace of God that passes all understanding. You not have the understanding that you need unless you let Christ live and dwell and reign in your life. As God expands your territories, it will not be always be as dry as it is. Things will not be as frustrating always as they are today. God is going to open doors for us and expand our territories because he is faithful and he is just and he is a good provider. But as God gives you those things, whom are they God coming to find? When you are disorganized from within out, hata kama ukipatua mali gani utaitawara aje? Do you see yourself being able to administer a shop in this head and another one on the other head and another one on the other head because you have been so blessed but there is no peace? Utakuwa namna gani? Si utakuwa mwendawazimu? Hey, you may not agree with me, but don't think that much is what is going to bring peace. It will bring more destructiveness, more lack of peace, more lack of, you know, everything. You just feeling nothing is satisfying. You don't even have peace to trust that, you know, God is in control. It is my before the Lord that I repent. Sometimes I have been very much worked up. My children, oh, how are they going to be now? I don't know. So and so with her husband, God, help. You know, the children, how are they going to be? And I'm sure you are not any different from me. Mothers, we worry so much our children like it doesn't have a future for them. Do you know that before you knew them, he knew them? Do you know that he had a plan for their lives? If he had a plan, what is he doing with those plans? As I repent before the Lord, I tell him, God, carry out everything. Even if they have to pass through fire, wacha wapitie. Mungu atawatolea pande ile ingine wakiwa na amani. Is that your prayer with me? Is it? As we live in this world, we need the gift of peace. We need to be indwelt by the peace of God. And the peace that God is asking us to have is not the peace that is just surrounded by worldly materials. It is the peace that Christ gives. And as the Lord Jesus Christ was going back to heaven, he told his disciples that, my peace I give unto you, not as the world gives. Not as the world gives. Because the world can be able, you can get every material thing in this world, but without peace, which God gives, you'll not be peaceful. This morning, as we came from our home, we discussed a certain president. And my daughter enlightened me. I didn't know that Trump is a billionaire. I didn't know. But she told me, you don't even know he's a billionaire, not just a millionaire, and maybe more than that. But is he in his second or third marriage? And I'm not about to disparage our president over there. Because peace is not always reigning. It's not peace. It is not money that reigns. I know for the Kenyans, we say, kama ungekuwa na pesa angeridhika. Kama ungekuwa nayo, ungekuwa namna hii. Nothing will change unless the peace of God indwells you. And the peace of God that passes all understanding, that gives your mind the peace that you need. And you need that peace. You need that peace to be able to sleep through the night. Because some of us do not even sleep. We sleep half the night, up to 11, 1, from there up to 5 a.m., we are just thinking, business. Vire haitafauru. Vire imeanguka. Vire nani alikuwa ananinuruhia sasa haji. Sijui ni nini rifanya. 5 a.m., when you are supposed to be getting ready to wake up, is when you are dozing off. And you'll be a very tired, irritable, and very disturbed person throughout the following day. The peace of God that passes all understanding. Answer the devil and tell him, before I had this business, God was there. Before you, I started, God was already there and he had plans for me. Before I had that, this family, si Mungu ulikuweko. Before I even went to say, I do, and vow in front of the people that I'll do whatever a wife is required to do, God was already there. If you are there, what are you doing now? The situation is as bad as it is. Well, how are you helping me? And God, you come by. God would want us to have a lot of peace. A lot of peace. When peace like a river attendeth my way. You think such songs were sung by very happy people in this world? Huh? Can you sing it with me a little? When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to know, it is well. It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well even you without doing anything. It is well. Because the peace of God is indwelling you. The man who sang that song and composed it had just lost his whole family into the sea. But from there on, he had a song for us. Sio vile utakuwa umekaa leo. You have no message to tell if everything was peaceful. Otherwise, what would deliverance come to do in your life? Does comfort people to come to people who are already comforted? Does people who always come, peace always come to people who already had it? Huh? Even God cannot give you something that you think you already have. It is for you and for me to cry and to call upon the Lord to give us his peace, so that as we expand in this divine expansion, and mark you, it is divine. If God finds that you have no peace to administer what he can give you, he will withhold it because it is a waste. As he would plan divine expansion in so many things, it can be withheld because you are not ready. Until you settle, and until you have the peace of God, and until you are able to go to the master plan of peace and ask him, what do I do? Things are as bad as they are, Lord, where do I go? And to keeping peace is, when it is within you. Don't look for it from other people. Wengine tumepatiana kifunguo ya furaha na peace kwa wengine. So only my husband, if only he behaved this way, I could have peace. Let him not carry your key of peace. Carry it yourself so that you may know where to open when you need that peace. And you can only open in the drawers of the Lord Jesus Christ and derive it from there, imprinting. Our men are not the carriers of our peace. They don't have any themselves. They are also beggars. And so our children, hata wakisoma na wapate degree zile za juu sana, bado ni watakuwa wakuomba for that peace. So show them the drawers where the peace is kept. And the peace, the drawers are with the Lord Jesus Christ. Draw close to him, he will draw close to you, and you have the peace of God. And may the Lord bless us and help us to look for peace. Amen.
It is well.
It is well
with my soul.